Good morning, student. I am Vinay Srivastava, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronic and Communication, and this is the introductory video lecture of the digital system, that is CS304. So here we discuss about the outlines. There is a prerequisite. What is the initial requirement for the subjects, course objectives, introduction of the subject. Why study digital system? It is very important. Why we study digital system in present scenario? Classification of DCS, industrial application, and real life example. It is important point. Both are important point. How we relate the subject with the industrial application and real life example. Syllabus, objective of lab work, because lab is also associated with DCS, lab experiment. And after completion of course, what is the course outcomes which are carried out? At last, reference and textbooks. So now we move to the prerequisite. As we know that a basic idea of number system and Boolean algebra is very helpful for understanding the initial concept of digital circuit and system. As we know that in BT 104, that is the one subject of the first semester or in second semester, that is BEEE, we discuss about the number system and Boolean algebra already. So all the student having this basic concept, which is required here as a prerequisite. So now we move to the another slide. After prerequisite, what is the requirement? What is the course objective here? So the course objective is, because whenever we study any subject, there is a requirement of course objectives. Understand the basic concept of digital circuit and system, Boolean function minimization, able to design simple and complex digital logic circuit, also verify, test the functionality of the logic circuit. So if we are talking about these, so and first understand the basic concept. Minimization is required, because whenever any function, if we minimize them, there is a requirement of the less variable and the expression is reduced. For this, we also use K-map technology. And when the expression is reduced, the designing is very simple. So then we move for designing process, either combinational or sequential. Discuss in previous slide, what is the combinational and sequential. And once the design is final, then we go for verification and testability, whether the designing is correct or not. If the exact output or not. So these are the objectives here. Introduction of the subject here. So in introduction, if we are talking about a signal is an electromagnetic or electrical current that is used for carrying data from one system to another. So signal means it always carry the information from one place to another. Like mobile communication, we transfer the information from source to destination, either transmitter to receiver. So it may be in the form of electromagnetic or electrical. It is depend on what type of the communication are required. So like broadcasting, TV communication, mobile communication, satellite communication, each communication we transfer the signal. So here we are talking about the type of the signal. So we have two type of the signal. We have more number of the type of the signal, but here we are concentrating about analog and digital. There is a random, deterministic signal, discrete signal. So analog signal is a signal which are continuous. So which defined at every instant of time, like sine wave and cos wave, they are continuous in nature and time. And amplitude of sine and cos is continuously changed with respect to the time. While in digital, we have only two values, either zero or one. A digital system is a signal that is used to represent data as a sequence of separate values at any point in time. So in analog, we have a infinite values, while in digital, we always use zero and ones, two values. Computers also understand the digital values. So we have a limited set of data, so we can easily detect and correct the error in digital. That's why digital is better than analog. Now, we discuss about the introduction of the subject here. So this is DCS. First, we find out the Boolean expression. Then we reduce this Boolean expression with the help of K-map technology. K KMAP technique. And when the function is reduced, then we go for the circuit. Once the circuit is final, either it is sequential or combinational, then we go for verification, as we earlier discussed. And once the verification and testability is final, we design the circuit. So this is overall flow process for designing of any digital circuit system: Boolean, reduction, circuit, and verification. Now we move, why the DCS required here. So we compare between analog and digital signal, which one is better, and with the help of this we decide this is the analog signal. So we compare analog and digital. This is the digital signal. So if we are talking about here, if we compare both the signals, so in this analog signal, this value, sine wave value, is continuously changed at every instant of time. It is continuous in nature. So it is defined for every instant of time. While in digital, we have two value of voltage. This is ground value, that is 0 volt, and this is 5 volt. So it can, 0 volt can be considered as a logic 0, 5 volt considered as a logic 1. So we have two values here, only 0 and 1. If the signal at 5 volt level is represented logic 1, high voltage or on condition, while the signal goes down and touch 0 voltage, it is logic 0 or off condition. So in digital, we have 0 and 1. 0 is also known as low voltage, 1 is known as high voltage, 0 is known as off condition, 1 is known as on condition. So we have a pattern of 0 and 1 here. But here we have infinite values in this entire range. But here we have only two values. So we can easily detect and correct the error, because we have two symbols, either 0 and 1. We can easily find out the error and we can easily correct the error. So here I mentioned error detection and correction is in digital system. That's why nowadays digital system is widely used. Okay. And the voice quality is also better in digital system in comparison to the analog. So this is the concept why we study digital in nowadays. Classification of digital circuit. We have widely classified in two categories, that is combinational and sequential. Combinational circuit is without memory, sequential circuit is with memory. So whole syllabus are divided in two parts, that is combinational and sequential. Combinational means the circuit output is totally dependent on present input. There is no dependency of output to the past inputs. It is the depend only present input. Output is totally dependent on present input. The output doesn't depend on past input. While in sequential, there is a memory element. Output depend on present as well as past input. Okay. So like half adder, full adder, half subtractor, multiplexer, these are comes under the category of combinational. While we are talking about flip-flop, receptor registers, that is the memory element, are comes under the category of sequential. So in syllabus, we discuss about both combinational and sequential circuit. Now, industry applications are important here. So this is basically one industry application plant diagram. Here, this is the plant. In plant, automatic plant, there are various type of the sections are required, like temperature, there's oven are required, and there is a pressure is also maintained. So in automatic plant, all the sections are synchronized to the each other. Whenever the temperature or pressure is exceed a certain limit, the plant is automatically shut down. So this is plant. So this is suppose a device which measure the temperature here. This is the pressure sensor. So these are the sensor which measure temperature and pressure. So these are the comparator. These are the comparator. So this temperature output given as a positive terminal here, and the pressure output given to the positive terminal of this comparator. So we have two comparator. At the minus terminal, we have references. So the references is that in the references, we have set a particular value of the temperature here and particular value of the pressure here. So when the temperature is exceed this reference values, when the pressure is exceed from this reference value, okay. So then what will be happen if दिस पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल इज ग्रेटर देन निगेटिव टर्मिनल, तब बोलते हैं वो क्वांटिटी विच अप्लाइड ओवर द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल इज ग्रेटर देन निगेटिव टर्मिनल, द कंपैरेटर प्रोड्यूस आउटपुट वन. This is the OR gate. We know that this is OR gate. And what is the condition of the OR gate? When any input is 1, the output is 1. The 1 means activate the command, that is shut down the command, then shut down the plant. If that, suppose that if temperature is increased as a reference value, so this positive terminal is greater with respect to the negative terminal. So the output of comparator is 1, though it is 1 feed to here. In OR gate, any of the input is 1, output is 1. The command is activated and this command is shut down the plant because the temperature is exceed to the limit. Suppose that temperature is within the limit, suppose that this value is less than reference value, so they always produce zero. Suppose that pressure is also limit, in limit, so the value at the positive terminal is less in comparison to the negative terminal, so this also produces zero when both the input, both the output of comparator is zero zero. So input of the OR gate is 0, 0, output is 0. 0 means off, the command is not activated, the plant is not shut down, they are in running proper condition. But like pressure is increases with certain limits above the reference value, so this voltage is high, so the output is 1, and any input of OR gate is 1, output is 1. Output means command activated, shut down the plant because the pressure is exceed the reference limit. So this is the logic of which are used at industry application here, that OR gate belongs to the digital circuitry. Okay, so this is the industrial application here. Now we discuss real life examples. We also discuss here like digital mobile communication is also digitalized, TV and broadcasting. Nowadays we use digital setup box in which the quality of the picture and video is better than previous one. As we earlier discussed, we use only two symbols, then we can easily detect and correct the error. In mobile communication, TV communication, is satellite communication is also important. Our computer are also important for digital, because computer understand only digital language 0 and 1, either in term of microprocessor programming, either in term of microcontroller embedded system programming, we are done in on the based of the digital. So there are widely used digital technology nowadays. Now this is a real life example. So how many number of the theory lectures required unit wise approximate? So initially we have required 10 lectures because there is a need of some basic concept. Then we move for second and third unit, we require 9 and 10 lectures, and 8 lecture required for unit 4 and 5. Overall 45 lectures we completed this syllabus approximate. Now this is the university syllabus. I am highlighting some important point here. So initially we have number system, logic gates and KMAP. So here KMAP is important because initially number system and logic gates we also cover in BT 104. So in second unit we cover combinational logic circuit, that is half adder, full adder, encoder, decoder, multiplexer. In combinational we already discussed, there is a without memory. Third one, these are the sequential circuit, flip-flop, register, memories. There is a requirement of the memories. In fourth unit, we study about the converter, analog to digital and digital to analog converter, multivibrator, symmetric trigger, CMOS and NMOS. These converter are very important. Sometimes we require digital signal, but we have only analog signal. Like your voice is analog signal, but once we talking over the mobile, it must be converted into digital because the mobile is understand only digital. So how we can convert voice into digital? With the help of this converter, analog to digital. At last, we are studying about the communication, Nyquist sampling theorem, time division multiplexing, pulse code modulation, etc. So these are the syllabus. So lab is also in this subject. So what is the objective of the lab? An ability to operate lab equipment when we perform the experiment. So we develop ability to operate lab equipment like CRO, spectrum analyzer, different kits, multimeters, to understand the basic digital circuit and verify their operations. Definitely we use the testability and whether the truth table and the output of the function is correct or not. Design basic combinational and sequential circuit with memory or without memory. Identify various digital ICs and verify their operation. It is important because we perform the experiment over the breadboard where we use integrated circuits ICs. And before using these ICs, we verify the operation, and we also checking the functionalities of these ICs, because there are lots of the pin are available on IC. So what is the function of individual pins? We can develop the ability to verify, measure and record experimental data, readings, analyze result and prepare a laboratory report. Finally, we prepare a laboratory report on the basis of experimental data, reading and results. So list of experiments, we have some list of experiment to study the verified truth table, gates, experiment related to the Boolean functions, experiment related to the Polladder binary to gray code converter, multiplier, combinational sequential circuit. And also we have some experiment related to the comparator, 4-bit ripple counter, timer, etc. So we have different type of the experiments here. Here we have mentioned 10 experiment. We have more than 10, and we perform more than 10 experiment. So these are the course outcome. At the end of the course, student will able to understand after completion of course. So the course outcome one, differentiate between analog and digital signal. Definitely we understand what is the digital, what is the advantage of digital over the analog signal. So definitely we differentiate and which one is better. Apply Boolean laws and KMF for minimization, because for designing we minimize the logic function, so we use the concept of KMF. Design combinational and logic sequential circuit, combinational and sequential both circuit, memory or without memory. Identification of various ICs, because when we perform the experiment, so we develop the ability to identification of the ICs and their characteristics along with operations. And finally, ability to understand the function of digital circuit under simulated and real time environment. We use the simulation environment, we use different type of the simulator, and we design the circuit and checking the output here. So different type of the simulator are available. So here reference and test box are available. So these books are also available in central library. Morris Manu, Digital Circuit, PHI publication, Ottman, Malvino and Leach, Top Selling, Simon Hikins. These are some books that the publishers are mentioned here. So we use these books as a reference or test books. So this is the overall introductory video lecture of the digital circuit and system. So in the upcoming video lecture, we are starting with the initial topic of the digital circuit and system, that is the number system. Before number system, we are talking about some advantage and disadvantage of binary signals and basic terminology of the digital circuit and system. Then we move to the number system. In number system, we cover all type of the number system. And after completion of number system, then we go for Boolean function and logic gates. Thank you, students.